Tech Harmonics. This is a kind of a really neat technique. I've dialed up my gain. If you're playing it on a clean amplifier setting with no distortion, it's going to be a lot harder for you to make this happen. So I would recommend using a distortion pedal, or if you have an amp with a master volume and a preamp, turn the preamp all the way up to get that growl that you need to make these harmonics happen. So basically the technique itself involves we pick the string, and immediately right after we pick the string, the fleshy part of the thumb hits the string and causes the harmonic to happen. Why does this happen? Well, strings are covered in what are called overtones. So if I play down the string, you can hear all those kind of harmonics. If I play up higher and I use some distortion, you can hear them too. So all those overtones that are happening over top of the pickups, I can access them with my pick. I can do things like but anyway, I'm gonna show you a close-up of that, a couple different views actually, so you can understand it better and start to use the technique in your own playing. Okay, so here's a different view. You can kind of see. So what's happening there is the pick and the thumb are hitting the string. Pick hits the string first, thumb hits it right after. So that's how you make a harmonic happen physically. Some guitar players that like to use that technique are guys like Billy Gibbons, LaGrange, check that one out. A lot of harmonics in that solo. Satch Boogie by Joe Satriani is another great example of that technique. And Zach Wilde loves to use that technique. So lots of really amazing guitar players like to use that technique. We could maybe go through a little lick right now that might be fun to learn something in A, like an A minor blues scale. If I take my pick and I do the harmonics near the middle pickup on a Strat style guitar, I'll get these kind of things to happen. It takes a second to find it. So if you find that harmonic there, we'll try that lick. It's kind of in the style of a Satch Boogie or something like that. So I'll play it really slow. So we go. So the idea, we're just doing pull-offs. We're picking the harmonic and doing a pull-off, then pick the next harmonic and pull-off like that. So that in the tab and you can start practicing that, but again, make sure that you have lots of gain on the amp, otherwise you'll have a hard time making the harmonic jump out like that. That technique, the first time I heard that was probably Jimmy Page on the Heartbreaker solo back in the, I think it was, would have been the early 70s. I heard Randy Rhoads doing it as well a little bit later on in the 80s. And that technique, basically, it's not really tough to do if you have a tough thumb, because you gotta kind of have a lot of callus there, or at least kind of build that up, because it will hurt if you press too hard on there. Basically, all you're doing though is you're pushing on the G or the B string. You can try it on the E or the D, but it's really tough to make those ones bend. But the G or the B, you got lots of clearance there if you're playing a guitar without a tremolo bar. You don't want to do this on a tremolo bar guitar, it's pointless. Tremolo bar that pulls up, you can just do it anyway. So you want to have like a Strat style guitar with no tremolo or something like that, or even a Telecaster, it works great on that too. Here's a close up of what it looks like. I'm starting here on fret 12. Just doing hammer-ons and pull-offs like that. And then we just take our thumb and put it here, right behind the G, like the nuts right here, right there. down on that one, tremoloing here, and I get a really neat sound. So it's. So I could push up on that, and then my hand comes down, and I can do a harmonic. So this time we're talking about one-hand pull-offs and hammer-ons and stuff like that. So basically, you're picking one note, and you're letting the hammer-on and the pull-off do the rest of the sounding of the notes. So you need to pick every note, pick one note, and all you're doing is muting after that point. So the scale that I'm using here is called Phrygian Dominant. It's mode 5 of harmonic minor. It's a little bit advanced probably if you're a beginner, but something popular with Yngwie Malmsteen uses it all the time. Any neoclassical type player will be using that type of scale. So anyway, memorize again the scale. Get the linear version of the scale on the string before you try to do the technique itself. Using those notes in the scale, but basically the idea is to hit the first note, it's a hammer on, then a pull off, then a pull off again, like that. So pick, hammer on, pull off, hammer on, pull off. Down in groups of three, or actually groups of four. So one, two, three, four. And it comes back up, but one group of notes lower. So one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So on the last one, it kind of resets itself. It just starts coming up. In seconds and until it gets back to the beginning again. So that'll all be written down on the tab. The idea here again, when you pick the first note, what I do is I rest my pick right there on the next string, the B string that's adjacent to the E string. So that way, if I hit the B, you can't hear it because it's being muted by that finger. So I rest it there. First note, you're already resting your pick on the B string, so you can pick that first note. I change this note here to make it segue to the chord I'm going to, A minor. And then at the end, harmonic on the E string, which we covered in Five Things to Make People Think You're Amazing at Guitar 1. So it goes harmonic on the 12th fret there, harmonic on the 7th fret on the G, harmonic on the 7th fret on the B, harmonic on the 12th on the E, little E, and harmonic on the 12th on the B, and kind of like a tremolo with your volume knob. You can turn it up and down. That's a nice little kind of a subtle thing you can do at the end of like a tune when you're kind of doing a ritardando, slowing down, and then you hit this nice thing like that. So like, tremolo picking. So that piece there that I played was a piece called Etude No. 2 by Kreutzer. Van Halen quoted it in his solo called Eruption. and I'm going to show you how to play that. As it, I think it's a good example to kind of learn to be able to tremolo pick on. It stays on one string, which is a little bit easier to tremolo pick when you're doing that. So anyway, let's get the technical details of how to pick that way. I'm going to do a little close up right now, and you can see how it actually looks close up to pick that way. Okay, here's a close up of the technique that I'm using. So if I took my pick and I use these two fingers, I go like this and I rest it like that. I'm basically just going like this. So it's all on the wrist like that, right? And you're focusing on that one string. And then the other technique, so that takes, that's going to take a bit of work to get that, but your wrist goes like this basically and just practice on it. Some people are really natural at it, and I had a buddy that could just play super fast like that. He couldn't really play guitar, but could play super fast like that. He had a fast twitch reflex, I guess you'd call it. I'm still not that fast at it, but I just do my best. Now, the other way is kind of the stiff wrist way of playing. So you're going... So it's kind of like you're using the wrist, but you're also using part of the arm. When I do that, I can feel my tricep tense a little bit, so that's something to kind of keep in mind. And you're just trying to focus on the smallest point of movement there. I'm using these two fingers for that. All right, now that you understand the technical details of how to actually make that work mechanically, let's talk about the melody. The melody for the song is pretty simple. It stays on one string. It's basically in the tab, you can see it. It's 8, 12, 15, like that. And I just go first finger, pinky. You can kind of see what I'm doing here. And then it goes 13, 12, 13, 10, 12. And then it starts again, does the same thing. So 8, 12, 15, 13, 12, 13. 10, 12, 8, 10, 7, 8, then we're into a new part here, 5, 8, 12, 10, 8, 10, 7, 8, and it does it again, 5, 8, 12, 10, 8, 10, 7, 8, 5, 7, 3, 5, 1, 5, 8, 6, 5, 6, 2, 5, 3, 7, 10, 8, 7, 8, 4, 7, then I did this little part where it goes 5 on the E, 5 on the B, 5 on the G, 4 on the G, 5 on the G, 7 on the D, 6 on the D, 4 on the G, and then end on 7 on the D. I think we did a chord there. So get that melody down first. Like that. And then once you have the melody down, work on the tremolo, and then you can combine the two together. So the tremolo, you just want to get on one string. Now the idea with the tremolo, you have to be careful not to hit the other strings, and if you do hit them, you should have them muted with your first finger. When I play one note like this, I'm muting the first with my first finger, I'm muting on the B string there. So if I hit that, it doesn't matter, you're not going to hear it. So get that technique down first. And start to move it around on the first part of the melody. So we'll go. So you get that down and gradually build it bit by bit like that. And that would probably be the best way to get tremolo picking down. Thank you.
So we can see here, I'm basically going to tap on the 12th fret all the way across. This is the technique, just like this. We go, so see how quick that is? You're just going like that. I see people do it and they kind of hold it too long and they go, and they press too hard. You can't press, it's not on the fret, it's right above the fret wire. So see how the wire goes straight down there? It's right above it and it's super quick, a quick tap. Then I do the next string.
So now that you understand the mechanics of how to tap a harmonic, let's run through a couple of simple chords to get you started on this technique. So I'm going to start off with an E minor chord, and we're going to use our second and third finger to play this version of E minor. We're going to be going to A minor after that, so we're going to tap back and forth on those two chords. We're going open, two with the second finger, fret two on the A, and then fret two on the D with the third finger, and then open G, open B, open E. And all these chords can be found in the tab. So look at the tab on my website and you'll be able to find that. So we're going to tap 12 frets above each one. That's where what they call the octave harmonic would be. So we have our open, two, two, open, open, open. So if we had 12 to each one of those, we're going to tap 12 on the big E, 14 on the A, 14 on the D, 12 on the G, 12 on the B, and 12 on the E. You'll probably find that it's harder to make the notes on the unwound strings, the G, the B, and the E, harder to make them pop out because they don't have as much mass as the wound strings, so they're not going to be as loud. If you tap nice and hard, you should be able to make it sound. Then we're going to switch to A minor. So A minor, we're doing the fingering like this. Open, two, two, one, open. That would be the frets. And we're using our second finger on the D, third finger on the G, first finger on the B on fret 2, 2, and 1, and then open E. So now when I tap that out, I have 12, 14, 14, 13, 12. So let's do that. And there you go, I've tapped one octave above each note in that chord. We can go back and forth. So work on that a bit, and as you get faster at that, then you can start to add in other types of harmonics. So another harmonic you could add would be the fifth harmonic, which would be found 2.5 steps down from any note that you tap. To put that in English, it means 5 frets lower than where you tap. So if I tap on open, like 12, like that, if I go down 5 frets, that'll be fret 7, I get this other harmonic, so you can hear them, like that. If I go down 2 more frets, I get what's called a double octave harmonic, which is going to be 2 octaves above the open E. So I'll tap that. That one's harder to get though, so a little bit of distortion might even help you at that point. So we have basically, if we do the E minor chord and we try to do a couple of those, we could go 12, tap on 12, tap on 14, tap on 14 on D, and then go down to fret 9. On the A and tap that, and fret 9 on the D. Sounds like this. So we have, sorry, do that again. So, like that. We can do the same thing on the A minor chord. We can go 12, 14, 14, 9, 9. We could even continue. I could go to 13 and go to 8, and I could go to 6. And that would be a fifth above that initial C note. So have fun with that. Just kind of go back and forth and experiment with some different chords and stuff and see what you can come up with. It's quite a bit of fun. Now I'm going to show you guys how to play that little piece I started at the beginning of this segment of the video. It's really simple. I use my first finger to go over the top of the neck. The reason I did that wasn't because it looks flashy or anything like that. It's because when I was kind of coming up with the idea, my fingers were getting sore, just kind of cramped in there, because, you know, if you're cramming 3 fingers in there, you can kind of get a little sardine-like in there. So I just decided I'll just use my first finger over the neck like this, and it made it quite a bit simpler. So what I'm doing there, I'm fretting on fret 3 on the D, the G, and the B, and then I'm using the open E string, and then I tap 12 frets above all those notes. So it's 3 on the D, so I'm going to tap 15, 15, 15, and then 12, like this. Like that. And then at that point, I'm going to use the fifth harmonic on the B string, so down 2.5 steps from fret 15. which means I'm going to tap fret 10 on the B, and then fret 10 on the G, like that, and then it just starts again. Now the second time it starts through, it doesn't start from the D, it starts from the G, so it goes. Then at this point, I slide the finger up to fret 5, and I tap on 12 frets above that, so fret 17. And I'm using my first finger like a bar, and I'm tapping the D, the G, and the B, like that, and slide back down. So. Then starts again. And at this point, I move over and I tap the D string on fret 10. Then I go 15 on the G to 15 on the B. Slide up again. Then I slide up again. And slide up 2 frets after that. Now you're going up to fret 7 with the first finger. So. And then it goes up to fret 7 and I tap 19, because 12 plus 7 is 19, so 19. And then because I don't have the open string there, because I don't have, it's not going to be an open string anymore, I got to double back on the G. So it goes 19 on the D, 19 on the G, 19 on the B, 19 on the G, and then down to the fifth below that, so 2.5 steps down on the B string. And so it's fret 14 on the B to fret 14 on the G, like that. So it's 19, 19, 19, 19 on the G, and then 14 on the B to 14 on the G, and then it starts on D again. The 14, 14, slide that up. Now I tap on 21, because I'm on fret 9 down here and back down, and it's tap 19 on the D, 19 on the G, 19 on the B, 14, on the B, 14 on the D, and then 19 on the G, and then 19 on the B. Then slide back down to 5 and tap on 17. And it goes back down 2 more frets to fret 3 with my index finger here, and I tap 15, like the intro. Slide back up to 5 here and 17 here, and then slide down to 2 with the first finger, and we tap fret 14, and then I go down 2.5 steps or 5 frets down to 9 on the D, 9 on the G, 9 on the B, and then open D string, I lift my finger up, so now it's arched, and I'm just barring on fret 2 of the B and fret 2 of the E, and I tap open D string on fret 12. And then I tap those 2 notes on the B and the E, like that, with 1 finger. That's the whole thing. So I went through that kind of quick, because this video is going to end up being like a half an hour long. But if you want to check the tab for that, it's on the website. And if you want to learn how to play that piece, that would be cool too. All right, good luck. I hope you have fun with that technique and write some of your own little pieces with that technique. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you got something out of this and that you're able to create some of your own music using these techniques. That would be great. If you're interested in exploring private lessons with me, I teach via Skype. You can contact me with the information on the screen below, or if you want to take a lesson in person, I live in Vancouver, Canada, and you can just, same thing, contact me and get a hold of me and we can set something up for you. Anyway, keep checking back for more videos. I'll be doing more of these types of things upcoming, and see you around.